when I was growing up in a city, MSP was just top tier. And so I always wanted to emulate that and wear a uniform.
My parents are both in law enforcement, and I saw the positive impact they had on the community. So I also wanted to have that contribution to my community as well.
I wanted to be a part of something that was bigger than myself.
And I wanted to be a part of the best.
When you show up on scene at someone's worst day, I like to be that little light in that dark place.
I think my transition into the department was pretty smooth. Once I got to recruit school, it was definitely a culture shock. I was challenged with many of different things that not necessarily used to, but I overcame that.
My background, investigator, and my recruiter made it very pleasant for me. It took approximately 6 months. The academy, it was hard. This was mentally and physically tough, but it was for the best. I leaned on my classmates and got through it.
I thought I was, as most people will, you know, assume that you're prepared. For me, it was the ideal of being away from family for the duration of a week. Truth be told, there were multiple Sundays that I was literally driving westbound on 96 with one hand on the steering wheel and one hand on a Kleenex and dabbing eyes for tears, you know, just being away from my child. So.
When I came in the department, we did have a wish list, but it was the total of 30 posts. Now, you get a top three pick, and you're more likely to get your first or second pick. So the likelihood of you being able to work in a post area that you desire is quite high.
I think what makes a good trooper is a trooper with a moral compass.
An honest person, a loyal person, somebody who goes out of their way to do the right thing at all times.
The number one quality you must have, you gotta be selfless. Courteous, you gotta be brave, considerate, and independent because, you know, this job is very self-motivating.
You can come from any background, any degree, any form of study or work experience. We really need that in the state police.
Being a woman in law enforcement is, to me, better than I think people would think that it is. I get a lot of respect, and sometimes I can relate to people on a level that the male can't necessarily relate to, especially if I'm dealing with a female. Some people might actually not talk to my male partners and just only want to talk to me. So I do get a lot of respect on the road, and I'd get a lot of respect at my post and in my department, really. So it's good.
I tried to spin that whole concept of this misnomer as to who we are as law enforcement men or women. Sometime this evening, I'll take off this uniform and I'm just the next guy. I'm someone's neighbor, I'm someone's son, I'm someone's brother, and I'm a little girl's dad. And so to humanize myself, I think is a great benefit.
I think that majority of police officers are really out there to do the right thing.
I think the only way you can change that misconception about us is going out there and interacting with the community. And you go out there and you make that contact with people. I think that's the biggest way to change that misconception.
I was actually trying to make a relationship, build a rapport with these people so that they know you're a real person. You know, we have families and stuff too that we gotta go home to. And I think the more authentic you are, the more that they'll respect you. I guess I wanted an exciting career, something that I can come to work and it's different every day. Just putting on the uniform every day, being able to put on your badge, when you kind of work so hard for something like going through recruit school, it's really rewarding to have gone through that. Not a lot of people can say that they've gone through that process. So when you put on your badge and you put on your uniform, you know you went through something that nobody else really went through. It's the best job you could ever have, the best decision I've ever made in my life.
If you see a trooper, we're very approachable. Sit down, come go to your nearest post. Don't be reluctant, you can do this too. Most people don't think they can do the job, but you'd be surprised what you can do. Just come sit, talk with us, and we'll get you on the way.